So today we are discussing a special case of pointer, and this is known as pointers to function. Okay, so in this particular program we will create a program which will inside that we will create a function pointer. Okay, so how do we create function pointer? It contains address of function similar to how many names is address of first element, function name is starting address of code that defines the function, and function pointer can be passed to function. It can be passed to function, stored in array, and assigned to other function. See, sometimes what happen if we declare one function like this? This is sum. So this is very smallest function, okay, and you can use in main program. Like, I'm not going to explain you function pointer, but just I'm showing how function pointer you can enable. Okay, so suppose c equals to integer c, we need to declare sum 59 comma plus sum 12 8. So what will be the output of this? Okay, if I am printing this, printf percent d comma c, so it will print 9 plus 4 14 and 12 plus 8 20, 20 plus 14 34. So it will print 34. Okay, why? Because this function is treated as variable. Okay, this function is treated as a variable. I can show you by example also, or you need to believe in me, just try by yourself. Okay, or let us show. So I'm showing one example which will use all the functions. So here I'm writing one function, the name of function is integer sum. Okay, inside that I am passing integer a comma integer b, and this will return. Return a plus b semicolon. So this is our function, and we can call it integer c equals to sum 7 comma 8 plus sum. And one beautiful thing is also there, 6 comma 7, and you can pass this function as argument also, sum 9 comma 8. Okay, so what will be the answer of this? The answer of this is 7 plus 8 in one iteration plus 3 argument it will not take, only 2 argument. Okay, so this will take 6 and another plus 9 plus 8. Okay, so likewise, and let us print this. So here you can see that the summation is 38. Okay, so this is the way. Means if the function can be treated as variable, so why not a function pointer, a concept of function pointer will be there. Okay, so this is defined inside that function and very small function. Okay, and the prototype is used here. So I will show you the example here. Okay, some different material you have seen here. Fine. So this is our program. Just try to understand it. Okay, we are using the bubble sort algorithm, and you must rely on logic. What logic we are going? Only one function, function pointer we will use here, and I will show you a little smaller example also. But just try to understand. The example is very simple. Sorry. Function to pointer contains address of function, similar to how array name is address of first element. Function name is starting address of code that defines the function, and function pointer can be passed to function stored in array and assigned to other function pointers also. Like if I want to declare a 1 equals to sum 9, 2. Okay, so this is also possible, and even this is also possible, a2 equals to sum a1 comma a0. Okay, so a variety of ways, like whatever in whatever terms you can think about, so it can work like that. Now come to bubble sort. Bubble sort is a program where a bubble takes a pointer function pointer. Okay, so bubble calls this helper function. This is helper function. Okay, we are using inside helper function is defined inside the function declaration. The argument in bubble sort for this function pointer is bool. Bool type of this argument. Bool means it will return true or false. Okay, so whenever I am writing if a, it simply means if a is greater than or equals to 1. Okay, if a is true, and this is also similar. So likewise here it will check whether it is 0 or 1. Tells bubble sort to expect a pointer to function that takes two integers and return a bool. Okay, two integers. So necessarily we are passing here a1 and a2 or ai or ai plus 1. Okay, so let us check. If parentheses were left out, then this will become this type of function. Declares a function that receives two integer and returns a pointer to bool. Here returns a bool to function. Here return a pointer to means two integer returns a pointer to bool. Okay, here it is function pointer. So just try to understand, and let us see this function. So this is our bubble sort. First argument is a pointer. Second argument is integer. Third argument is function. This is pointer or array. Okay, now this second one is the maybe size or maybe type whether you want to use ascending or descending. I'm not saying anything, okay? And this is function pointer. The name of function is compare. Here we are using compare function. So integer order counter and a size. So what is our size? Size is 10. Okay. So this size is 10 size array is given here. And one can enter. I had several times I told you that this can be entered by user, or you can also enter by your own. Okay. So enter one for sort and two for sort in ascending and sort in descending. So maybe this is type. Okay. Ascending one, descending two. So let us see the definition of function, because this prototype will not say anything. And then for counter equals to zero, counter is less than or equals to size, counter plus plus, this will print the actual array. And this will print array in ascending order. And this particular will print okay, but here it is not doing any printing job. So this is a function pointer, and actually this particular thing will perform the printing. Okay, this will do the job of, it is array in ascending order, it is not printing anything, it is not printing anything, it will modify it in array only, and this will print the printing array in desired order. Now this program ends. So here we will start. This is actual array, and the name of array is A. Okay, so although we are using var, but modification will performed inside this A. So this is the beauty of pointer, and this function returns nothing. It means it works inside this only. Fine. Now come to constant integer size. So this pass, this will pass the size of integer. Okay, so what is the size? Size is 10. Now compare. This is the function which we are using here, and you won't be able to say that whether this is a function or something else. So this is a function because it returns bool type. Okay, so this function is declared here. This function is declared here. Compare var count comma var count plus one, whether this is greater or less. Okay, if it is greater, if it is true, if it is true, whatever is true, it will automatically swap accordingly. Okay, so let us see. So this is our swap function, and this is pass, number of passes which we use, and the counting. So count number of pass 1, 2, 3, 4 up to size. Okay, so it will start from 1 to 9, because less than is given here, and the size is, count is, this is our pass and this is count. Count is started from 0 and up to 8. Okay, why 8 and why 0? Let us check. 0 is because you want to compare A0 with A1. Okay, and 8 is because you want to compare A8 with A9. And if we put 9, then what about A9 and A star? Because we have no 11th element. Okay, so that is the reason why we are using eighth step. Now this will compare. This function will compare. We have already declared that this is a function of type bool. So it will return. This function automatically will return either 1 or 0. So it will compare, and this will counting. Okay, this will start counting whether count equals to 0, count is less than or size. So this you know very well. So compare work count. Work count means the value of count start from 0. So work 0 is greater than work 1 or not. If it is greater than this, so automatically it will produce the answer. Fine. And the swap function will swap the elements. So likewise, this function will perform. So how function pointer are called using the dereferencing operator star? The star is not required, but emphasize that compare is a function pointer and not a function. Okay, so if you are not using star, then also it will work, but because we have used this, so it will automatically tells that this is a function pointer. Maybe this example where we have not truly used means utilize the function pointer. So we will declare that later on. And this is our ascending function. Ascending function will check. So here we use the ascending or descending order. It depends how do we use ascending and descending. Okay. So swap function is there, swap function, and this is the ascending. If ascending integer A, integer B, so this will automatically return the swap value. Okay, so where we have used ascending and descending, we have not used ascending and descending. Yes, we have used this function here. Okay, so now just try to understand that we have used the function here and we have declared the function pointer here. So let me copy this much. This portion is very important. Function pointer is not in your syllabus, but I need to show you that function pointers also exist. So that's why I had used this example. So this is our function, okay? And this is the function pointer. So this compare will point ascending if ascending is given, and this function will point descending if descending will be given. And this is the condition. This is the condition. So it will return true. When it will return? In case of descending, if B is greater than N, B is greater than A, then it will return true, okay? In this particular case, in this in ascending, in descending, B is greater than A, and in ascending, A is greater than B, so it will return true. It will return true. So whenever it will return true, then only swap function will be called. So any doubt related with this? Anyone?
So what are you asking?
Any doubt related with this function pointer? This compare is a function pointer which will compare ascending or descending. When I write pointer to function, pointer compare Well, actually, see, in the first, that's why I'm asking. This is a function, okay? This is a function which we pass in bubble sort algorithm, and there also we pass the function. Fine. So whether now this function will pointed by this compare, okay? So when we will po pointed by this compare, it will automatically call the dedicated function. So what function it will call? Okay, so it will call because already ascending or descending we have passed. So ascending it will call or descending it will call. Fine. So accordingly, according to call of ascending and descending, this function returns a Boolean value here. This function returns a Boolean value, either true or false. Return B is less than A. So it will each and every time it will return 1 or 0. If 1 is returned by this function, it will swap the element. Okay. And in this particular case, if 1 is written, see in ascending order, what happened? 1, 2, 3, 4. Likewise, we want to write. So suppose again 2 is written. So this will be swapped. Means if A is greater than B or B is greater than A, so in this particular case, either A is greater than B or B is less than A. In both the cases, swapping will be done. So because this is written in terms of B, otherwise this can be A is greater than B. Any doubt? Just try to run this program by your own and then ask me if you have any doubt. So I will forward you this program. I will show you the execution also. So this is our program, okay, ascending and descending. And it is pointed by a function pointer, and this function pointer is compare. Okay, just I am going to give you a clue. So this is used, and the passing function is like bubble A ascending and descending. Okay, so this is our passing function, maybe ascending or maybe descending. So this is very simple thing. So this is a bubble sort algorithm. There is no problem. Size is passed, ascending and descending is passed. So whenever I am going to pass ascending or descending, so this is a function. This is a function written here. Okay. So this function automatically compares the value. Okay. This will automatically go here and compares the value and modified accordingly. So this is the function pointer. Okay. So I am sending you this. And after 20 second, I will try to. Actually, I'm going to delete the group. Okay. And I want to switch you to Signal. Or if you have the Signal account, then please join this. Okay. So section B. Section B. This is given to you.
सर ये है क्या
क्या चीज?
सर सिग्नल जो कह रहे हैं आप प्राइवेसी
सिग्नल एक्चुअली क्या है? व्हाट्सएप अभी प्राइवेसी पॉलिसी वॉयलेट वॉयलेट कर
हाँ
रहा
सर हाँ
है
सर
ना? तो आपके पूरे कांटेक्ट वहां पर चले जाएंगे, आपके पूरे डेटा वहां चले जाएंगे, जो भी हम बात कर रहे हैं, जो भी चीजें हो रही है वो सब व्हाट्सएप यूज करेगा कमर्शियल पर्पस के लिए। सो आपको पता होगा कि हमारा जो वॉइस है वो भी एक डेटा है ना?
यस सर
सो वॉइस
यस सर
कमांड से भी हम मान लो किसी को फोन करते हैं, थ्रेटनिंग कॉल करते हैं, तो वो भी हो सकता है। तो
यस
व्हाट्सएप यूजेस अवर होल डेटा, and that's why I want to switch myself from WhatsApp from myself from WhatsApp to Signal. So Signal is
ओके
not
सर
yes Signal is not that much perfect, but it is good for communication.
सिग्नल तो वही है ना जो एलन मस्क ने रिकमेंड किया है.
हाँ अभी आपने यूज किया होगा ना, व्हाट सारी चीजें वैसे ही है, बस आप इसमें स्टेटस मैसेज वगैरह नहीं भेज पाते. ग्रुप वगैरह क्रिएट हो जाएंगे है ना, तो मे बी मैं एक सेक्शन को डेटा स्ट्रक्चर पढ़ा रहा हूँ, शायद बी सेक्शन ही है. तुम लोग पढ़ लोगे मेरे से, दूसरे सेमेस्टर में लगातार?
यस सर.
क्या बात है, गुड. चलो अच्छी बात है, गुड. तो जितने लोगों के सर्टिफिकेट रिसीव हो गए ना, वो सारे लोग असाइनमेंट में फाइनल सर्टिफिकेट लगाएंगे. सर्टिफिकेट लगाना है ना, कि कोर्स का जो एक शीट आती है ना, सर्टिफिकेट जैसी शीट आती है. सर्टिफिकेट में मींस स्पेशलाइजेशन लिखा रहेगा, स्पेशलाइजेशन इन सी प्रोग्रामिंग. इसके अलावा असाइनमेंट मैंने दिया, उसको ध्यान से देख लो, हो सकता है मिड सेम में उसमें से कोई क्वेश्चन भी आ सकता है. स्पेशलाइजेशन में तो फोर कोर्स लिखा होगा ना, फोर कोर्सेस.
यस सर.
हाँ इट्स वेरी सिंपल. All forces course, all four courses will be given there.
But okay. हमारा तो लोगों के लिए नहीं हो रहा है, वो कार्ड मांग रहा है, तो इसलिए से कोर्स अटका ही हुआ है.
आपका क्या हुआ है?
सर वो जो कोर्स करने के लिए बोला था उसका एक सर्टिफिकेट तो हो गया है, बट आगे मैंने आपको बताया था कि वो लोगों ही नहीं ले रहा है बिना कार्ड के.
हाँ तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं ना, आप असाइनमेंट करो, आपको असाइनमेंट करना ज्यादा जरूरी है.
Yes, sir.
है ना, आप असाइनमेंट करो, एक सर्टिफिकेशन ले लिया, गुड, वेरी गुड. लेकिन असाइनमेंट आप पूरी ईमानदारी से करो है ना, और हैंड रिटन असाइनमेंट है ये.
ओके सर.
ठीक. तो अब हम एक और कॉन्सेप्ट डिस्कस करते हैं, दैट इज स्ट्रक्चर. स्ट्रक्चर्स, ओके. Give me one second time. So let us recap on pointer once again. Very small thing, very little examples are there. Generic pointer. This is a generic pointer you can assign to any kind of value. Void pointer p, this is assigned, this is created by you. Integer I and integer c. So p equals to address of I, it will become integer pointer. And p equals to address of c, it will become character pointer. So how do you use this? Either put care or you can use some other thing, okay? So don't go on put care. It lose all information about what type of thing is pointed to, reduce effectiveness of compiler's type checking, okay? And it cannot use with pointer arithmetic. So you can assign any kind of value, fine? So type casting, here put care, so character pointer is given and pointer inside that. We will, so tells the compiler to change an object's type for type checking purpose, does not modify the object in any way, and it is dangerous, and sometimes it is necessary. Until and unless you find it is necessary, then only you will use. Actually, when we use void pointer, sometimes what happened, we have declared a lot of data types and lot of data, and you want to modify it. So how do you modify that data at the end of file? Okay, so at the end of file, you need, if you want to modify, then you need to use pointer. So if you know that what type of data is, then only you can, and whether so many pointers are there and some other things are there. So to avoid such thing, we use void type of pointer later on in program, because in previous days, what happened, a lot of lines are there inside the program, maybe 10,000 lines of codes are there in their programs. So this is a pass by reference function. We know very well that void set x and y. So whatever we are giving here, the value of a is 1 and value of b is 2. And if we pass this, okay, so what will be the output upon, if this is another function, this is one more function. If we use main program, so in this main program, it will automatically modify the value of a and b. So this is pointed by x and y, and then this will modify it. So is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Arrays and pointer, you know that what is array and what is pointer. So both are the similar things. If you are writing pointer, okay, and array is having a multiple dimension, okay. So to access any particular value of array A, you need to use, you can use this type of pointer. I already quoted in previous example. It is array name equals to a pointer to the initial zeroth element, you know. Then address of a 1 is equals to a. So both are same thing. An array is passed to a function as a pointer. The initial size is lost, okay? So we are not giving the size. Usually bad style to interchange arrays and pointer. Avoid pointer arithmetic, okay? Avoid pointer arithmetic like this. I know that compiler can do this, okay? So just do not show your programming skill very well that someone is unable to understand. So use always, this type of referencing is very good, and don't use this type of referencing. Like this can be B5, A6, whatever written is, it is very simple. Okay, so this can be used like this. Fine. If array, anything you want to use, if like A1, so how do you use A1 star A plus 1? Okay, so don't use this type of arithmetic in arrays. So this is a function, size of A, size of A. What it will print? Size of A will? It is printing 40 or 10. So this will print 8 because array is really a pointer. It depends. And this will print 40. Fine. Now come to this. So there is nothing special about this. Pointer arithmetic, strings are also given. So this is very short file. Now pointer to pointer, we have already used this function star character star argv and then this type of thing. So if you remove this, you can use another pointer. So this is very important thing, that dot slash program hello 123. If you write this argument total, count the number of argument. This is the program to count the number of argument. Okay, so here this also I had explained you in previous classes. Now come to structures and union. Fine. So structure is, what is structure? Be able to use compound data structure in program, be able to pass compound data structure as function argument either by value or by reference, be able to do simple bit vector manipulation. So like this is very simple structure. And in assignment also it is given a date. Date is integer, integer and integer. Okay, so you need to write a structure. Why structure? Suppose I want to ask user for enter date of birth. So this time what happened? We use integer DD, MM and YY. And then user will enter the date. So whose date? Whose month and whose year? We don't know. So that is why we use a complicated, means compound, not complicated. So compound data structure, struct a date, okay? And then this will be close. So again, if we write a struct a date date, so automatically it will create the date type of data and date dot month. Now, if you want to access this data, so this is declaration and we need to write a struct date or just put here type def, okay, type def struct a date and then followed by once again write a date. Then you need not to use this struct keyword, okay? So it depends on you whether you want to, because you are not writing type def integer a b c, okay? But why, if you have developed your own data, then why you need to use a struct? Like if you want to create a date, okay, so you need to write struct a date and date. Now this will access your date, month and day like this. So this is known as struct, and this struct, this particular struct will store how many bytes? So it will store 12 bytes. Okay, and you can use unsigned here. If you want to save more, then you can unsigned short. So this will give you very small. So this is the size of field, and this size of field will automatically give you the size of struct. Okay. So sometimes what happens, we need very small data. it is not necessary that we use heavy data. So that time, if one information is not there, then it will automatically use blank, okay? Character C1, C2, and integer I, it will take 4 spaces. So for this purpose, one padding is required. This padding will separate the data, okay? Otherwise, what happened? We will understand the whole thing as integer. So that padding is very, very important. And this is used as Latin Endian notation, so don't go on this. Mechanism of new type creation, okay? So here I had written type depth long integer 64_t. So overload existing type names for clarity and portability. Next thing is type depth struct a date and then date. Yehi maine aap logo ko bataya tha. This I had already told you. So here integer 64_t, this is threaded notation, okay? I equals to this much size, you can declare. Similarly, date, yes. One important thing, whenever you are using structure, so structure can be initialized with this curly brace, okay? And each is going corresponding to this particular place. It simply means that d dot month, it is d dot day, and it is d dot year. Okay, so this is the structure. Constant, there is already array of a structure you can declare very easily, like date type of birthdays, and then number of friends. Okay, and for number of friends, you can use this. So you need to write a program which will enter P and Q points are given in your tutorial. Okay, so for this purpose, you can write a structure point, and this point is it consists of integer or float P1 and integer P2. Okay, so this, and if you want to declare a structure, you cannot declare directly. Okay, you need to write line by line and then followed by semicolon. In last, you need to put semicolon like this. Create date is a function. Okay. If you use pointer, okay, if you use pointer, then you need to write pointing notation. The date of D, date of day of D, and day of means year of D. Fine. This is another example. This function is a create date function, and we have used pointer, date type pointer, and we will pass 3 values. Okay, we will pass 3 value. So this is a very simple example, very, very simple example. So what happened? We need to write whatever value is passed here. Okay, date is today, and address of today, we are passing 1/18/2018. Okay, we are passing this. So it will modify at this particular place because I had defined like this. So day of D and year of D automatically change. So here how it is changed, you can see. Okay, so D is a pointer. Its address is 1000. Okay, D is a pointer and its address is 1000, means it is pointing to which? It is pointing to this location. Yes, this shows very clearly it is pointing to this location, and it will modify accordingly. Yes, one more important thing, date type D you cannot write directly. It requires a pointer, and that's why be careful when you are using a date type of function. So आई हैड वेरी फास्टली टॉट यू दिस कॉन्सेप्ट बट इन लेटर क्लास आई विल एक्सप्लेन फाइन. So this is another concept called union. It is very similar to structure, but the size of union is not strict. Okay, you can use means like here union A an element. Okay, so integer I is given and character C is given. So total size of this is the maximum size of any element. So maximum size is shown as 4 byte. Okay, so union will require 4 byte to store, only 4 byte to store. So it will store character here in 1 byte. Okay, and remaining 3 byte will be utilized for integer. But in a structure, what happened? If we create the similar kind of structure, it will take 8 byte. We will see the size of this. Okay, let us see. It is much better to explain you using the example. Okay, we are not having sufficient time. So just I had given you a brief idea about structures and union. So in next class, maybe in Thursday, I will explain how do we use the structures and union. Okay. Any doubt? Maybe a lot of doubt today due to structures and union, but I will clear this doubt on Thursday. And on Thursday, we will complete file related operations. Fine. And then the course will be concluded on that day. And then we will start revising using programming. Okay. So just ready for a revision. So thank you very much for today's class. Have a nice day. Have a nice time.